So I've been working on a project that uses multimedia, mostly video and animation, to help teach medical students, residents, clinical fellows how to do what we call non-surgical medical bedside procedures. These types of procedures can be associated with a certain amount of risk because they involve putting intravenous lines into vessels in the neck or putting tubes into people's trachea or windpipe, putting tubes into their chests. So even though they're not being done in the operating room, they do carry a significant risk associated with complications or doing them improperly. So this type of project was intended to be used as kind of a new instructional tool to tap into different ways that people learn. The idea for this came from the thought that people learn in many different ways. So some people are very visual learners, some people learn just by you instructing them. But this type of tool will combine all of those things, hopefully combine all of those elements that will appear to different people's learning style. And so hopefully create a more complete picture of what they're actually expected to do when they're asked to do a certain type of procedure. So once I've got an idea for what type of video I want to do for a specific procedure, I script out the narrative for that video. So exactly what a voiceover is supposed to do in order to instruct a student. And from that, I storyboard the video out, and then I film the video and I edit it and I produce it in a way that turns it into a CD or a DVD type of interactive package that someone can use. The ideal use for this is a resident needs to do a procedure in the middle of the night, has possibly done the procedure once before, seen it done once before, but needs a refresher and needs a very visual refresher. And so they're able to download this on a website, either locally through Sunnybrook or University of Toronto, hopefully someday, or via a broader website like the New England website, and then get a step-by-step instruction on how to do it.